Okay.
Make sure. We need everybody to scoot in.
Oh, you want all of us?
Oh. Okay.
Oh, yeah, everybody.
Really make me self-conscious about my
hair. I know,
hair,
right? I'm just like,
this is a terrible hair. Light. I'm just going to...
All right, I'm just like...
Definitely more waves from this end, so...
Yeah,
like,
I'm kind of like...
Is everybody in there?
My face,
yeah, yeah, everybody
there
like squeezing in, like it's
yeah.
Here we go. All
right, just say like, you're listening to Across Campus on KUPS.
Okay.
You're listening to Across Campus on KUPS.
Stay crunchy lagers.
Yeah.
Stay crunchy
okay.
Lagers.
Good morning, everybody. You are listening to Across Campus on KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma. Every week we bring in specific student groups to bring in a perspective. Last week we talked to the incoming class of 2016 about their experience thus far as a member of the freshman class. This year, this week we've got some new students in, but from a different perspective, we're talking to some transfer students. So pretty soon I'm going to turn it over to them to talk about their experience, but I just want to thank you all for coming in. I'm really excited for you all to be here and excited to hear what you have to say. So for the first segment, I'm going to let you guys introduce yourselves. If you will tell the audience your name, your class year, and when you came to UPS. So you guys can start.
Alrighty, so my name is Brittney High. I am a second semester freshman, class of 2015. What else were we supposed to say?
So you entered last spring, University
yeah,
of Puget Sound.
Yeah, I entered last
okay.
spring.
And so did I. So I'm actually also a transfer student. So I went through transfer orientation with Brittney, so I'm really excited to talk to you guys one transfer to another. So that's great.
My name is Cory. I am a junior. I transferred just this semester. I graduated in 2014.
Great.
And my name is Jesse. I'm also a junior and I transferred this semester, so 2014 as well.
Perfect. Okay. So two fall transfers and one transfer from last spring. We got a good group here. So next question, I just kind of want to know what you guys are doing before you came to UPS. That can be any number of things, if you were going to school, if you were working, if you were taking a gap semester, sort of what, and as much as you'd like to talk about that, it's sort of up to you, but what you were doing before you came here.
So for me, I ended up just skipping a semester, graduated high school, had to help out family, so I couldn't really start in the fall like I wanted to, but still all the same, still here.
Great.
When I graduated high school, I went straight to a four-year university, and it was a state college, very big, and didn't like it, so decided to go to a community college and worked for a little bit. I started working full-time. That took up a couple years, and so finally meandered back to finish my BA.
Great.
I was finishing community college and planning my future here.
Planning your future here? What do you mean by that?
So I had big ideals and big plans about going here. So a lot of my future was based around whether or not I got accepted and how I was going to take on that next level for myself.
Great. So that must have been a huge relief when you ended
up there. Yes and no. Like I had like great things lined up for both situations, but I'm glad that I'm here.
That's perfect. You're a planner, which is great. So I guess the next question that stems from the last one is why UPS? Why, of all places, are we all in this small school in the north end of Tacoma? What about UPS drew you here? If you want to talk about if you considered other schools and what distinguished UPS from those other institutions of higher learning, you can talk about that. So it's sort of up to you.
Well, for one, I love the Northwest. It's awesome. I've been to Seattle like once before this and fell in love with it completely. And I did actually consider University of California at Santa Cruz, but turns out like I was going to start in the fall, didn't get accepted, so helped out family anyways. So this was my second choice. But still, it's a liberal arts school, and I don't have to go all the way to the East Coast to get this great education here.
Absolutely.
So it's really awesome.
Yeah, I mean, very similar reasons for me. I mean, I've always been in love with this area of the country and have kind of held it on a pedestal, and I'm so glad that I finally made it out here because, I mean, I feel like it's one of the most beautiful areas in our nation.
Totally.
So, yeah.
I was looking for a smaller school, and this kind of fit a lot of the criteria I had. It was kind of near a big city. It had a decent downtown. I've liked exploring Tacoma so far. And, you know, it's within some good hikes and good skiing, so it's got a lot to offer.
Yeah.
So I'm a Tacoma native and had heard a lot of about UPS from other students, and it was kind of a snowball effect. A lot of people kind of added to it until the point that I kind of had UPS on a pedestal and was like, I'm going to make it happen. So the class sizes and the programs offered here are probably the biggest pushes for me because I have friends that are going to University of Seattle or UW Seattle, and they're like, yay, class sizes of like 300 plus, and my professor doesn't know who I am. And people's accounts about how when going here, you know, their professors would even go as far as calling them and be like, why didn't you show up? Like, you know, I'm worried. We want you to do well. And that's like a huge difference from the type of like teacher-student relationship that I'd seen in the past. I want to go to Japan, and all of the study abroad programs and the Asian studies program here are just huge. So that's one of the reasons why it probably became the only school that I applied to. And I had everything set up so that if I didn't get accepted, I was going to reapply, but be very aggressive about why didn't I get in and what am I going to do and what are you going to do as a school to make sure that I get in this next semester.
Absolutely. And sort of as a follow-up question, we actually had another Tacoma native last week in the studio as an incoming freshman, and she talked a little bit about the relationship Tacoma has with UPS, and as a transfer student, I was wondering if you wanted to add anything to what you feel about that.
So I think it depends on where you're from in Tacoma. I can definitely say, yeah, I go to UPS, and people are going to be like, oh, you go there? And then there's going to be other people who are going to be like, oh, that's really great. What are you going for? What are you going to do? And they want to feed that idea, and they want to get something back from it. So I think that's the side that I was, that's the side of the street that I was on. I wanted to build on that idea, and I wanted to be a member of that community.
Great. Well, once again, thank you guys for coming in to talk to us. We're going to take a quick music break, but you've been listening to Across Campus on KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma, and keep listening. We're going to talk a little more when we come back. Good morning, everyone. You have been listening to Across Campus on KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma. This is Carol, and today we are talking to some transfer students about their experience at UPS thus far. And the next topic that we are going to address here in the studio is transfer orientation, how it may differ from the freshman orientation we heard about last week. And we have both spring and fall transfers in the studio and how those experiences may be different. So if you want to go ahead and hear a spring transfer talk about, we actually went through this process together, so I'll jump in if I have anything to add. But it was a pretty unique experience in snowy Tacoma. So go for it.
Sure. When I got here, it was actually snowing and freaked me out. It was the first time I'd ever seen snow. I'm from California, so I was like, what is this white stuff falling from the sky? What is this?
We have
maybe like an inch of snow per 10 years.
Nothing
maybe.
Like what was happening last year.
Yeah,
right?
it was like
snowpocalypse nuts.
Type thing going on there. But yeah, we ended up meeting in like the rotunda, and there was about 10 of us, and then we ended up just like hanging out, talking, pretty much like getting us into the campus. And then we ended up doing some community service on the beach, which was really awesome.
Yeah,
we got to
see,
we got to see part of Tacoma, like drive around, see the city. It was really awesome.
Commencement Bay, yeah, I remember that. And I remember when they did the orientation piece where we wrote about the potato.
Right.
That was so funny.
That was awesome. Analyzing a potato.
Yeah, I mean, my question is, when you came out of that, did you feel it was beneficial? I think it was beneficial for our transfer community just because there were so few of us, but sort of going back to you as a second semester freshman, what was that like being with other freshmen that had gone through fall orientation together?
It was pretty different. Like, I've heard about the fall orientation, like, being completely amazing. And, like, you know, you going out into the woods and, you know, bonding
right.
together and stuff. But since it was only about 10 of us, like, for spring semester, it was, you know, a really put-together moment. You know, like, we still talk and stuff, which is, like, really awesome. So we don't really forget that much, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I distinctly remember sort of being in the rotunda and all of us introducing ourselves, and it was a pretty great group, definitely very different people coming from very different places. I mean, transferring into UPS in the spring is a super unique experience, so I think everyone has their own reasons for doing so. Great. So, Jesse, how about you?
Definitely one of the reasons I chose this school was for their orientation. It was so... It was practically like a week long, and you know, you go out into the forest and you do activities, and even though you're with freshmen, you're meeting up with a lot of other transfer students, and it's really kind of that community building starts before school starts. So that's really nice compared to other schools where they just throw you in and go, here's how you log into the library, and that's about it. And it's nice to have several days together with other students, and you're just kind of that transition period from whatever you're doing before then to back into school mode. It was really worthwhile. I liked it a lot.
So I was so enamored with the idea that I was going to school here that I would get on my Cascade and check, like, every day. Was there something new? Did I miss something? Is there something that popped up that I can do now? And I stumbled across the orientation link and started, like, kind of going through it, reading it, and I was like, pick your camping trip. What? This is amazing. Like, and then I was, like, telling people, I was like, I need to go on a camping trip. And the orientation week really made it for me, because beforehand, I was living off campus, and I was going to be commuting in, going to my classes, commuting back home, and after orientation week, I wanted to live on campus. Like, I came right back and was like, I want to know what I need to do to make this happen. I met with a financial advisor. I met with other people on campus to make it so that this was going to work for me. And so now I'm on campus. And the bulk of people I know from campus are the people that I went through all of those different orientation things with, which makes a huge difference because I know I can walk out somewhere and see somebody that I know.
Yeah.
I'm not feeling alienated. And I don't necessarily know how it would feel to not have that. And that was probably what makes college scary for a lot of people, is going into that kind of situation where you're like, I'm the brand new person, I don't know anybody, I'm going to stare at the ground and walk to class.
Right. No, absolutely. I mean, I think it was a bizarre situation for us, because when we arrived here, we didn't have class for a week because of the snow days. And I remember that feeling of, we didn't go through that extended orientation. And at that point, pretty much the only people that I knew, and you probably had the same way, the people I lived with and the people that I had gone through orientation with, even though it was a very much truncated orientation compared to the fall. And, I mean, now definitely I think we've all branched out, but that those initial first weeks, especially as a transfer student, I think because there are less of us, it's definitely hard. I mean, Jesse, do you feel like a lot of your friends here are still people that you went through orientation with, or have you?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, it's grown, but it was a great kind of jumping off point of just people you knew and people you could sit down and have lunch with. You know, you weren't, like Corey said, just staring at the ground on your way to class. You're looking for friendly faces because you had, you know, a big pool to identify with. So it's really unique and beneficial.
I think one of the things that I remember from going on passages was the take your cool cap off. And
yeah.
I know it sounds so corny, but it definitely made a difference in being able to feel comfortable going up to just perfect strangers and saying hi and, like, connecting with them. I mean, sometimes now in the sub, if I'm sitting there with somebody and I see somebody go and sit alone, it's like, no, don't do it. Like, come over here, sit with us. And the only thing I'll know is, like, we were on orientation week together, and
right.
then we can connect with that, and then, like, instantly move on to something more important and more in the now. Like,
absolutely.
What are their classes, and how's it going?
So you both were at Camp Parsons, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Right. Did you do the backcountry backpacking and the Cascades?
Yeah, I just did canoeing.
Canoeing, okay. And what program did you do?
I did the day hike, and
okay.
That was really focused around not choosing something that was going to make me like the lame duck of the group. Because I was really nervous about signing up for something and then being that guy that was stuck, you know, trailing behind. Wait up, guys! And so I picked the day hike because I knew it was going to be easy for me, and then I could focus more on making connections with people and enjoying myself, rather than like trying to, you know, conquer a mountain and not like die on the way there.
Right. The emphasis being on community building as opposed to
yes.
strenuous hardcore backpacking, which is good. I think. I think that the pressure is off, and that's really great. And I guess my last question is, as far as orientation went, I mean, everyone is there at Camp Parsons in the fall, freshmen and transfers, and was there a lot of sort of meeting all people, freshmen as well, or did the transfers sort of stay?
We were stuck with, I mean, at least my group was all freshmen.
Okay.
So I did, you know, I wish that next time they kind of put transfers a little closer together or have activities that just involve the transfers to kind of start that cohesion a little. I mean, we eventually all grouped up together anyway, but just to help that cohesion get started earlier would be nice.
So I know the idea was to put all the transfers together, but then when you select different activities, there
mm-hmm.
aren't enough transfers selecting those different activities.
Right.
So there definitely was a mix. And I did feel that slight disconnect with it being transfers and freshmen. However, coming back onto campus, a lot of things were really focused around transfers, all the transfers doing the things together. And kind of the numbers, there were like 600 new or so students, and 60 some of them were transfer students, and only approximately half of those transfer students actually did orientation.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, not a huge pool of people all selecting the same thing to bond together, but I don't think that it took from it at all, because there were a lot of opportunities while at camp to do things with other people.
Right.
You could choose a lot of your own things, and you kind of found the other transfers, like, oh, you're a transfer too? And then the conversation
sort of
happens. Like, yes, common ground,
yeah.
I found you.
That sort of initial, hey, are you, yeah, me too, okay, great. That sort of initial getting
yeah,
that,
yeah.
that
you,
first
you
moment.
Can pick out who's
yeah.
not a freshman pretty quickly.
But yeah,
so
I mean, even
there's something
the first sign.
I totally agree. I mean, there's that sort of, you're new, but I don't think you're a freshman with people, you know, get to know each other. And I guess the last question I have on this segment is more geared to you, Brittney. If there's anything that you would like to see from spring transfer orientation, because I feel like there's a lot of room to grow, maybe potentially if there's something maybe that you could pinpoint or one thing that you think could be improved about spring transfer orientation, because it's definitely very different from the fall.
Yeah, definitely. I think the one thing that I would want to say is just like have us be able to choose to go to the fall transfer orientation thing, because like I feel like the spring semester, it was kind of just thrown together, like, yeah, let's all hoard all these people into the rotunda and, like, let them analyze a potato and go let them do community service.
We'll
you know?
Learn more about
but
this potato analyzer.
The
it was
potato,
intensive.
It was pretty in a group of about, like, five people. And it was kind of like our introduction to liberal arts. Like, what is liberal arts?
Mm-hmm.
And so we analyzed a potato from, like, various aspects, like, what are the dimensions of it? What is
not
I
eat potatoes.
I actually do still love potatoes. I think about potatoes as I eat french fries and things. Like, why are they curly instead of straight? You know, things like that.
It sort of bonded us in a way that was different.
Yeah.
Because we were all so, you could tell that everybody was so sort of, everyone had this look on their face. And we were all spring dancers,
yeah.
and it's a totally different experience. We were all kind of like, oh my gosh, it's snowing, and everyone's sledding, and we're in here. And
we're in here holding potatoes. But, like, it kind of gave us a way to, like, open our minds to, like, what do other people think about certain things?
Yeah.
So, like, you know, some person would be like, oh, well, the dimensions of this. And, you know, another person would be like, well, look at the color, look at the smell, you know. And so you kind of got each other's personality just by having potato. And I thought that was really awesome. Very well put together. But
absolutely.
At the same time, it's just like we were kind of just sitting around other than like going out and doing things and helping each other out like for fall semester. And I thought that would be really interesting to do. So it's kind of sad
Absolutely.
That I didn't get to,
yeah.
but, you know,
no,
it's
I
still
agree.
Pretty awesome.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys for sharing. That sort of concludes our segment on orientation. This is Across Campus on KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma. Keep listening. This is Carol Prince, and stay tuned. Good morning, everyone. You have been listening to Across Campus. This is Carol on KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma. This morning, we have been talking to some transfer students, Brittany and Jesse and Cory, and they've been sharing with us their experiences thus far at UPS. The next thing I'd like to talk about, which you guys can go into as much detail as you want to, is the kind of amorphous, what is it like to be a transfer at UPS, the social aspect. And that can mean any number of things relating to how you operate here as a member of this UPS community with a different background than a lot of people here who entered as a freshman. And I guess one of the more direct guiding questions I always use to think about this is when you meet people, when you're meeting people that aren't transfers, do you introduce yourself as a transfer or do you sort of let that happen organically? And what have you kind of noticed about this community? So, Brittany, you want to start?
Sure. When I usually meet people nowadays, it's kind of an organic thing. Like, if they bring up that they didn't really see me fall semester of last year, and I tell them that I'm a sophomore, then they're like, well, why didn't I see you fall semester? Then I go into the whole detail about how I'm a spring semester transfer and things like that. But usually I don't really go out of my way to say so. Just, like, unless it comes up, it's kind of a natural thing.
Yeah, Jesse.
I kind of figured, you know, you have like an icebreaker period where, especially all the freshmen are brand new, so they're all eager to meet new friends. But as a transfer, you know, you're generally breaking into kind of already established social groups. And so, yeah, you know, I bust out that I'm a transfer and just kind of letting everyone I meet that, like, you know, I'm new and I figured I can use that for a semester until it gets old. And, but yeah, it's definitely different meeting people because, you know, you're brand new, but not everyone else is that are in most of your classes. So it's kind of, it's a slower process, but it's been really good so far.
Calling it organic is very UPS. I just have
yeah,
to say that first. I don't necessarily tell people. I let them ask, and I think it's a little too AA meeting to be like, hi, I'm Cory, I'm a transfer, I've had an issue for a while now. But I do tell people, because they ask, they're like, why haven't I seen you? Or, you know, they do assume that maybe I'm a freshman. But I notice a difference in, everybody knows everybody. Yeah, I live in Trimble, and, like, everybody knows everybody, and then there's, like, these few people that nobody knows, and they just happen to be transfers. So I do notice that I'm starting off slightly behind some people, but I'm kind of excited that after this semester ends, I feel like I might be caught up, or at least know enough people that hopefully good things spread about me.
Yeah, I mean, I transferred like Jesse, and from a big school where everybody doesn't know everything about everybody, and that can sort of be a double-edged sword, just like being a small school can. And I'm wondering if you guys feel that UPS being a small, tight-knit community works, and this is not a simple question, it's not necessarily yes or no, it does or it doesn't, but does that work to your advantage as a transfer student to sort of enter this really small community where, you know, you might get a lot of exposure, but sometimes social groups can be formed early freshman year? How do you guys feel about that, Brittany?
Especially being a spring semester transfer, I feel it's kind of awkward because, like, you're going in and you don't know anybody, but it's the second semester. So everyone's already, you know, starting to settle into their groups and, like, they already have their close-knit friends. So once you kind of get over the whole, oh my God, I'm so afraid, I'm going to transfer, and, like, I know five people from orientation, you know, you kind of just throw yourself in there, you know, like,
yeah,
just be
right.
ambitious. And you go to meet one person, they kind of invite you for their friends, and then word spreads. And that's kind of a good thing and a bad thing about a small campus, because you know everybody for just, like, hearsay, and things go around really quickly,
they
you know?
Definitely.
So it's like, there's a lot fewer people, and you kind of know people by word of mouth, and then, you know, social group, bam, there you go. But like you said earlier, it could be a double-edged sword. So it's kind of awkward, but at the same time, it's pretty interesting.
I definitely, I mean, I feel you on this brain transfer aspect. I mean, I think that in that case, I definitely went around and I'm like, I'm a transfer student because, you know, in the fall, you have vastly more people entering, new people, freshmen, transfers, people that are coming back after a gap semester. And then in the spring, when you really don't have that many new people entering, and I think that's when it's sort of, who are you? Oh, you're a transfer? Okay, great. And I mean, someone who lived with me walks me around campus and was like, this is Carol. She's a transfer.
I had the same experience. And like, this girl across the way from me, when I was living in Register, she was like, oh, yeah, let me just show you the campus. And she pretty much just took me around and said hi to everybody that she knew and said, hey, this is Brittany. She's a transfer.
Yeah.
And so, like,
hi.
You know, and I'm just like, oh,
she
follows
me.
That's, yeah, no, I mean, those people are great.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, I definitely owe a lot of my initial introductions to meeting people to work, so.
One thing
yeah.
I really liked, I mean, it's a small school, so you just get a tighter knit community. But people seem, like, abnormally nice here. Like, there's just more people are nice. In general, you know, it's like 50% of people are just you're not going to get along with. But here it seems that a lot of people are pretty, pretty good people. So it's been really nice and welcoming. Yeah.
So there was a scavenger kind of hunt for Dean Sagawa. And I had done this, it was all about the free food. It was all about the free food.
First
I wanted the
gravitation
free.
Gravitation.
Yes,
free
and
food.
So I was like, I'm going to do this. And going through that, I met a lot of people because people were like, oh, what are you doing? I'm doing this kind of scavenger hunt. And really, like, connected. Like, I went to one of the Senate meetings. I got a picture with the Grizz, which was a special, like, engagement because I had to have somebody find him, bring him to, you know, get the picture. But I think a lot of people responded well in that idea that they were going outside of necessarily their comfort zone and connecting with individuals like me and other
mm-hmm.
like other students that were brand new. Like, oh, you just started here. So I think people... And I've heard this from longtime students, individuals on campus make an effort to kind of step outside what they would normally be comfortable with because it kind of drives that whole home idea.
Right.
And that, you know, these people live with you. These people are your family in a way
right
now.
Can you explain Sagawa Scavenger Hunt to those listeners who don't know what you're talking about?
So there were 25 things you should do before or during your, like, first semester, and you had to do like 15 of them, and I completed it in 3 days. On the third morning, I had like turned it in because I didn't know if it was going to be like only the first person, and then I'm pretty aggressive about if I want something, it's going to happen.
What are some examples of things that?
So go to a Senate meeting was
okay.
one of them, and so I remember when I went there and I was sitting there, and I think one of the first things was, "Are you here to ask for money?" And it's like, "No, I'm actually here because I'm kind of like going through this list of things I should do." I rode around with campus security. I actually ended up doing that for like 30 minutes because we just started talking while we were driving around campus. And I kind of saw that perspective. And that was the goal, was seeing this perspective. I saw my teachers, like, in essence, their like academic resume, which I had no idea. I don't even remember the word that was used for it. It was super complex. But I didn't know that that was something that like all these teachers on campus had. I didn't know that like they had this extensive list of like all the classes they've taught, and
right.
what credentials they have, and where is their focus of study. So that was interesting, and I think it was a good icebreaker of something that I started to do on my own, and that helped me kind of branch out and open up. And now I see all these people. Divergence is probably the biggest thing, because I was sitting in diversions, like, with my list, and kind of, like, going through it, organizing, like, which one am I going to do next, how can I get this done, ASAP, you know, this is one of those things where if I write a letter, I won't get a response, and that'll take me, like, 2 weeks, okay, I'm not going to do that one, so moving on to the next one, and, somebody said something about my list, and she's like, oh, well, one of your things on here is talking to the editor of the trail. He's right there. I had no idea. So I went over and introduced myself, wrote a letter to the editor, and bam, I had him sign it off, and I was like, I was done.
There you go.
That's awesome.
That's pretty great. I mean, that's an awesome way. You know, at my old school, we have the same sort of 161 things to do before you graduate, and those are...
It's
a cool way to... too big. You got 4 years to
so
do it.
So did you end up having... dinner?
I haven't got my dinner yet. I want my dinner.
Advocate. Great. Well, we're going to take a quick break. You're listening to Across Campus. This is Carol. We've got three transfer students in the studio talking about their experience. You're listening to KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma. Keep listening and keep it on the sound.
Who are we listening to?
Lovely.
Brian asked me that. He's like, so are you here to ask for money? And I was like, instantly though, I thought, wait, what could I ask for money for?
Actually, anything you want. Any student can come through Sunday and ask for money for anything.
I'd like $2,000 for my room and board, please.
You can ask. Or we can say no. You'll know I asked because it's like, for real.
People are definitely more concerned on how they look at community college and like getting their financial aid, and I'm going to get respect when I go into that class, and here it's like, oh, I've got work to do, and I need to connect with my peers.
I feel like it's the same way, like, I was in community college while I was still in high school, and it felt exactly like high school, you know, like, people were like, oh my god, why are those shoes, and, like, with that top, and I'm like, I don't care, I'm going to a math class, you know, like,
although I will say, on campus, sweatpants, not okay, don't wear sweatpants in public,
or like a nice top with, like,
college. Yeah, but if people call, like, we have to go off the air in order to answer the call. Like, if we had somebody working in the booth back there, and if, like, we had a big enough staff, like, you can screen college beforehand and then, like, let them come on the air. But, like, otherwise, if they call this phone, like, I have to hang up, I have to, like, turn off the headphones here, like, go to a silent, then answer the phone. Get their message, turn it off, and then get back to
the air. Putting the color on the air is also really touch the process, and I don't know how to do it.
Yeah. Well, you have, like I said, you have to have somebody back here. And like, you can't have the telephone. Like, I just don't think it works.
Yeah, probably have to make it.
Yeah. I think I've had one or two people like actually call in, like, because they're listening to the show and they like wanted to contribute something. And then there was one person who just called in.
Can you guys play some music?
I'm like, it's a talk show.
Homebridge, it's a talk show.
It's actually a talk show, it's called Across Campus. We don't play that much music, but...
Well, you're going
to
do Across Campus, it's a talk show.
I think he thought I was like a DJ, but I was like going on a rant. So...
I'm going to suspend the music while I push my views on you.
I'm just saying.
What's that? Yeah.
It would be cool to have...
You need to wear that hat, that's a pink dot hat. Right here.
Well, I thought you were looking at my helmet. I was like...
I don't think it's really good.
Actually, you have to look at the camera every once in a while. If you can, like, look back and, like, smile at the camera every once in a while.
Oh,
because they're
oh man, 44 seconds, guys.
Yeah. Wait, this is two songs in a row.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, how many years later?
Thanks, Casey.
Yeah. Oh, great.
Good morning, everybody. This is Carol, and you are currently listening to Across Campus on KUPS 90.1 FM, Tacoma. We've got three transfer students in the studio, and we've been asking them some questions about their experience here. And the next segment is geared toward academics, and in what ways, if any, has being a transfer student worked to your advantage or disadvantage in the classroom, with work? Anything you'd like to talk about regarding academics, or we can open it up to broader, you know, how being a transfer is advantageous or disadvantageous, but sort of academically first, Brittany.
Sure. Academic-wise, it's pretty normal. Like, I feel like I'm mostly with the group, you know. People ask questions in class, that's what class is for. So it's kind of awkward at the same time, though, like in a writing type class or like a philosophy type class where they assume that you've already been through like a writing and rhetoric core or a scholarly creative inquiry core, where you kind of get the basics of what you want in a liberal arts type writing like style.
Right.
So it's kind of awkward in that sense, but I feel like it's pretty much the same. I mean, you kind of go back to your high school and like, well, what did I learn for English in this class, or, you know, things like that, and you kind of just apply that directly.
Yeah.
So it's pretty normal.
Because those core, I mean, those scholarly creative inquiry and writing and rhetoric and fine arts, those core requirements are unique to Puget Sound, so especially
right.
a lot of transfer students, that's sort of, when they were talking to me about requirements, I was sort of, it felt like they were speaking another language
right.
sometimes. I was like, you know what, I've been through freshman writing seminars, but sort of having to go back and sort of retake a lot of those was frustrating as a transfer, but you also, all three of us happen to be in the same class in a transfer seminar, so that's
right.
a really great way to meet other transfer students. So, Jesse,
yeah, it's
yeah.
definitely, it's a lot different than the community college I transferred from. And, you know, community college back home, it was by the end of the semester, half the class had dropped out. You know, and part of it's just because at community college, people have lives that demand their attention outside of class, whether it's family stuff or working. Whereas here, everyone's pretty much devoted most of their time to their studies, and that's been really nice. Just like locking into that that intensity of engagement. And as far as like classes go, it's been like a mixed bag. Some of my classes are definitely harder than others, and at first I was kind of worried that there's concepts that I hadn't learned yet and that everyone else had already known, but I quickly learned that everyone else was in the same boat I was of struggling to get through all the it's definitely a lot of reading, but it's been good. The teachers are very kind of welcoming during office hours. You can actually find them in their office during office hours, whereas teachers in larger classes at other colleges, you'd show up and the door would be locked and they wouldn't be anywhere nearby.
Definitely.
So that's been good.
I went to TCC. TCC was good. It helped me have a respect for different types of colleges and going here. So it definitely gave me perspective. The concern for people that I noticed at TCC were passing, not necessarily the same here, where it's like doing well.
Right.
And that's like a huge difference, and that translates into a lot of things based on how much of the workload that they're doing, how much they're taking out of that. I know that there's a lot more reading than I probably ever have done, maybe even all of my community college like added together, but it's just a dramatic difference in the expectations of the students, because they kind of set the bar, and the teachers kind of like take that and they run with that.
Yeah, I really like that the kind of norm is a lot higher, and the expectations are higher, so it's a lot nicer when you're meeting those, you're meeting higher standards.
There is a difference in acknowledgement. I think that I wouldn't have as much drive to do as well if I didn't know that when I went into class, having done all my reading and, like, understood it, that the teacher's going to be like, yes, that's it. You get it. Welcome to getting it.
Absolutely. Welcome to the way of getting it. There's a big neon sign at the door. But I completely agree. And also, I feel like because UPS has smaller classes, I mean, the average class size at my old university was anywhere from 100 to 300. You wouldn't meet people in classes. You would go into a class with maybe a couple people you knew or didn't, and you would sit and lecture, and that would be that, and then you would leave. And I feel like, especially in some classes, there's a lot of group project work, and it really makes it easier for someone coming in new to have class be another forum for meeting people, not just something you do or something that you go to. It's, okay, I'm going to meet people, and I think a lot of my good friends here actually have met through class. And do you guys feel the same way? Or?
Yeah, definitely. I remember, actually, last semester, my smallest class was, like, 12 people. And it was a seminar class, but instead of, like, lecture, like, everyone just getting shoved into this big auditorium and somebody just talking at you, it's kind of more interactive. So when people are raising their hands or asking questions, you kind of get to know them, like, on either an academic level or a social level or both, you know?
Right.
So it's, like, more discussion-based instead of just somebody talking at you, you take notes, and you go away, like, knowing nothing about the people around you. So I think it's kind of awesome in that aspect.
Yeah,
I mean, I think definitely classes have been, you know, it's one of the main mediums of meeting people. And there's just a lot of opportunity in class and then definitely out of class to get to know people, you know, and it's, yeah.
If you have anything to add or not, or...
What's the question?
I think we've pretty much addressed it as sort of class functioning as another way to meet people as opposed to, you know, just 15 people sitting down together and then leaving the room.
It definitely is. I think that there's some group projects kind of worked into everything. So that is the other way to kind of connect with students. Being transfer students, you don't have as many, like, previous connections. So current classes are probably the really great way to be like, oh, I had a class with you. Here's our connection.
Right.
Let's talk.
No, absolutely. So we are going to take a quick music break. You've been listening to Across Campus, and we're getting to the end of the hour here, but stay tuned. And this has been Carol with three transfer students in the studio on KUPS 90.1 FM, Tacoma. Good morning, everybody. You are listening to Across Campus. This is Carol on KUPS 90.1 FM, Tacoma. We are wrapping up the hour here. We've got three transfer students in the studio talking about their experience at UPS thus far. And I just kind of like to close out with the open-ended question. Let's say that a prospective UPS transfer student is listening somewhere in this great nation, and they are looking for not necessarily some advice, but what would you say to someone who is considering transferring to the University of Puget Sound? It doesn't have to be a cute little soundbite. You can do it. It can be, I mean, sort of what, and it can be as random as you like. What would you say to this person? You can take a minute to think about it, or if anybody has anything that they would.
Well, one thing, I went back to my counselor at my community college, and they push, you know, state schools and state universities pretty heavily, and especially in California, prices are rising. And I told her, like, please let students know just about private universities, because they offer financial aid. I think a lot of people are scared by the sticker shock, but, you know, there's help out there, and to not be turned away immediately just because you're afraid of the price, because it can come down with financial aid, and that's a big benefit to a lot of students. So that would be one thing that I've told a couple friends, to, like, just branch out and try, you know, doing applications for a wider range of schools.
Yeah, absolutely. Puget Sound especially is a huge draw for a lot of students. So I completely agree with you.
Brittany. Yeah, I definitely agree with that also, too, because, like, when I transferred here, that was my biggest concern, was financial aid. And I was thinking, well, how am I going to pay for this? I'm out of state. I'm going to, like, pay out-of-state tuition, but at the same time, it's like, the University of Puget Sound doesn't distinguish between in-state and out-of-state, which is, you know, a really good plus. And there's always financial aid. There's always scholarships available. If you, like, want to do it, I don't want to get all corny and stuff, but if you really have your mind set on it, there's always a way to do so.
Yeah.
Like, I'm dependent on, like, scholarships. And, I mean, of course, it's, like, a lot of work. You might have to, like, write an essay or something or a quick blurb about why you need this scholarship or something.
It's
but,
worth it.
Yeah, it's totally worth it.
Yeah.
One of the things I didn't understand in community college, and I saw this in my last quarter there, were students applying blanket applications across all the universities they could think of. They just found universities that offered something that they wanted, and they threw out all their applications. And I was like, I don't get that. You're not choosing where you want to go. You're just saying, who's going to accept me? So my thing to tell somebody would be, know what you want to do. I knew that this is what I wanted to do. I knew that this was where I wanted to go and how it would work. And I've pushed now for people that I know, like, I advocate for the college. I'm talking about, like, all these really great things that are on campus and all these things that you can do and what you can do with your education. And people get pumped. People get excited. And they aren't as afraid when the first thing that they're hit with is, like, the cost. They need to see the other things. They need to see what's beyond that, what they're going to take from it. What's the prize that they're going to be able to claim?
Claiming your education.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And so knowing what you want to do is going to be the biggest thing. I always think it's funny when I talk to other students and I'm like, oh, well, what's your major? Like, because that's the question I ask. I want to know what people's major is because I want to be able to connect that way. And, oh, I'm not sure. I haven't decided yet. And like, you're like literally, you know, driving extra hundreds of miles, in essence, of road, you don't know where it's going to take you. Like, sit down and kind of figure out what you want to do, where you want to go, because you're in a position where it would be better if you knew. And so knowing what you want to do is definitely, like, the biggest thing.
Yeah, it's definitely, it's easier to go for your goal when you have a direction.
When you have a goal.
yeah, right, when it's defined. But like one thing I noticed talking about like applications and stuff, I visited when I was looking at to where to transfer, I visited, I think about 10 schools, throughout the Northwest. And then I went over the East Coast for a little bit, and on paper, they all looked very similar, you know, small kind of liberal arts schools. But when I visited, they all had dramatically different flavors and, atmospheres and, it was so nice kind of getting a, even though you're making really kind of weird snap judgments because you take a tour for an hour and you walk around for an hour.
Would you say UPS has a nutty flavor or more of like a smooth vanilla?
I guess would crunchy,
granola.
Crunchy granola.
Crunchy granola.
That's
right. Soaking.
Yeah,
well, absolutely. I want to thank all of you for coming in and sharing your stories. I know that being a transfer student and what comes along with that isn't necessarily the easiest thing to talk about, and I really appreciate you guys sharing your time with Across Campus. On that note, you have been listening to Across Campus. This is Carol on KUPS 90.1 FM Tacoma. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure to tune in next week. We're talking about race and pedagogy in the wake of one of Puget Sound's premier conferences. So thank you for listening. Make sure to keep it on sound.